Ladies and gentlemen, Volume 2, Chapter 7, The War of Art, The Battle of Brigadoon. Praise from Caesar.
Sitting two and two together with the blue nun's bloody glue, the smashed gas of Lila Guino donned the Noah's Arcade crew by twinning shafts of ultraviolet light that disguised their zippy bungle with a torrential double rainbow that George welcomed to the jungle. The Grand Old Duke of Yorkshire spied 100,000 men marching up to the top of the Spanish coast and shook his head in disbelief again, bellying halfway across the neck to visit Gibraltar's rock like scuba diving tourists that would have hitchhiked the Penzance docks. Laughing at the audacity of the Yankee Doodle Dandy, Vorskel blew away the copycat with the breath of Hurricane Sandy, simply jacking them on his gambit with a tropic thunderstorm, playing the WWF game of Egyptian generals with the full retardant norm. Reaching the safety of the White Cliffs before the Pharaoh's chess equestrians channeled the English like Moses in a red sea of pedestrians, the burning bush from Washington Post to boil them some legalized train wreck and fill their aqualungs with hippie crap to keep them in nossing upon head check. And that's how you kick ass, girl. Stars and Stripes.
Credits for a princely sum and blamed the family jewels. Our armies marched by day to Greece, the only way the king could pay his dues to Rome for aid, like Alexander the Great in a man united state, Kentucky frying bait, stealing Zeus's thunder while he ate. I turn another page in the story of our rage, the sun beamed down from the heaven in a cage and struck them from afar. The heavy metal morning stars jamming in the pissed red devil's bars like 12 green bottles sitting on the Hague. So they flew in from the east, dragados burning their deceased, throwing China from the table, blacking out the sky with cable, cutting off the oil slick, like the right-wing party trick, lighting up the Mathout bank, where the colonel's poultry drank, tapping out his cold as Mars, from an ancient Trojan horse, for the special mincing queen of France, who was hacking at the brands. The sound of music blaring out in Scotland's yard, where the sisters dressed in black opened up the vat of sour wine for the rangers that were sweeping round the back. The heather on the track where the blue nuns sprung their trap, drinking in a secret hidden lair, an oasis in the sand for the Nazis' marching band, stealth fighting in the middle of nowhere, printing out the words for the aces' high-flying birds, as General Dredd sets in the pellier. So they charged them for a peace, posted in the Middle East, by the mail on Sunday, people of Sahara, Desert Eagle, dropped a coded stick of rock on the bunker busting jock, like an aircraft carrier pigeon playing Ivory Coastman's knock, targeting the tutor with a big upstairs computer, aiming for his brain with a laser guided shooter, telling retina scanning lies, shining red lights in his eyes, scrambling their intelligence while the Black Hawks bleached the skies. For the artful Sergeant Jack's monstrous regiment of hacks those exploding Yorkshire puddings that disappeared without a trace, that we buried with the proof in their empty coffin place. The breath of fresh air serviceman that's washed out of the cold bent copper pipes. Fill all of the Raquel lungs with hippie crack and burned their stars and stripes. The gunners live on fire that the frogmen told to dive, swimming for the channel hopping lives, laughing ghastly Irish over and rambled England over. From Calais to Hippie, but just in time to stop me nuking Wales when One Direction fails. A rocket in the charts at number 10. The Smiths came out to play for the Cardiff City Day. The escapades of bombing football men. The Arsenal hit the key from the minister while we smuggled 20,000 Premier League support our troops under the sea. So we dug into the land, building castles out of sand, spending all of Pharaoh's gold on the tower blocks they sold to the church for the stonemasons, but the gap in the foundations where the captain hit the wall with a Spanish cannonball, firing all the royal pains at the Laughing Stock Exchange, where our beachy head Cornwallis screwed up their marching orders and drowned the storming Normandy invaders in the water. The never-doubting Thomas wrote the backstabbing story of Monty Bryan's life, and donned the name of Ziggy Christ like Stardust on Russell's brand new Bowie knife. He knows the walrus with the spyglass on his beady eye, praying for the camera lens to dry. Took them by surprise, the cowboys in disguise, while they waited for the morning sun to rise. The spectacles we wound as they marched around the town, pictured in the black opticians who came to cut me down. Hang the Bill of Rights at the heavy crown of lights for the judge that turned the singing voices down. So the carpenter came out with things to shout about. Breath of God that blew out all the sound, a sermon on a mount that banked on John's account. Baptized by a Denzel's got talent scout, followed closely by some hair-washing Tony guy, searching for the checkbook of Eli's. So we drew our singing swords on the local shopping halls, who came from out of town to erase our gold records. The stands in the Francine that worked behind the scenes, pulling strings of senators that never heard them scream, and manipulative users, maxes from the losers, robbing the director of his award-winning producers, who paid pirates to hack and stab me in the back and set up the Archbishop's Canterburyan heart attack. Put the Russian Navy SEAL with the white stripes upon my shield, and charged the Arctic Circle with a trident as I heal, cutting off the guarded life preservers of Roman secret servers, the family of Swiss bankers that were cheating death deserters. So an angel saved the day, cause the hoppers couldn't pay back a soldier of fortune that we nicked and hid away. It's a fucking smash hit, girl. If you don't throw in your buckle five, who will?